buzzer, and they can win it with a last second shot, even inside. And here are some of the people that make our telecast possible tonight along the Cyclone Television Network. What a thriller.
Well, Iowa Hawkeyes, who 13-2 last year on the road. In fact, they had a sequence of Minnesota, Illinois, and Purdue road wins consecutive. And that saying something. They fought themselves back here and got a chance with the basketball on a one-point deficit. And to go back to that timeout, it's a crucial. You have to give up the timeout to maintain possession of that basketball. I did not see anybody coming from any direction. Signaling for timeout, players, bench, or otherwise.
Johnny Orr having a strategy session now. Now both teams are down to one timeout remaining. You talk about a costly turnover. That may be the turnover of the ball game. Iowa will have the ball out in the backcourt. 25 seconds exactly to play.
And the Hawkeyes had plenty of time to go inside, which is where they have wanted to go all night and get to that free throw line, even though they struggled a little bit there.
Tom Davis, 36-6 in his second year in Iowa. And the time is coming down. Armstrong, pick set for him up high. He'll take the shot. Not there.
Push off.
No. And a foul on Robinson. Robinson inside, and that is five on Robinson. And Iowa will go to the line with a 1-1 and 12 seconds left to play.
Well, they went to BJ, the money man. There goes Elmer Robinson. He's not seen a whole lot of time because of foul trouble. The shot goes up. Robinson coming from behind. You see him coming over the top, reaching, and no doubt about the call.
Well, Johnny Orr is going to take all the time they'll allow him right now to put a little ice on Ed Horton, who will be at the line. Horton's only a 55% free throw shooter, but so far in the ball game, he is 2 for 4. And it's going to be Dorfeld coming in replacing Elmer Robinson, who just fouled out.
That's a good break right there for Iowa State, because they still have the one timeout now. They're able to use the delay on Horton right here, who's probably the poorest free throw shooter on their club on the line, 55% coming in. And the crowd giving him the business.
It's good. It's tied.
That is pressure, and Horton responds to it. And that's what's great about this game, to play in a situation like this under this kind of pressure.
This ball game comes down to 12 seconds. That's how even it really is.
Ooh, that must have hit
it's
the
no good. It's no good, and Greer uses the last time out with the score tied. So Iowa State now has the basketball, the score tied at 90, and there are 8.1 seconds left to play.
Well, that's plenty of time. I thought that was airball. Must have hit just the
underneath
of the rim. Must
have just hit the rim and fell straight down.
If they hadn't painted that today, he wouldn't have caught it. What a basketball game. 8 seconds left, 90-90. Iowa State really has let the ball game slip away. And now Iowa came back. Let's see if we can hear Johnny. I don't know if we'll hear it.
Of Dorfeld. They'll go with three guards, Tompkins, Woods, and Bourne. And Greer gets it in the corner. 8 down to 5.
Cole Marvel against Dreher.
3, 2, 1. At the buzzer, it won't fall. We have overtime. And Johnny Orr wanted a foul, but there is none.
Well, they're not going to call a foul in that particular play, I don't think there. And Marvel did a good job to contest Dreher outside.
Now, as we go into the extra period, Iowa State will be without Elmer Robinson. I believe now Iowa State will get a timeout. Okay?
That's right.
So each team will have a timeout now. So we are going to play an extra 5 minutes. Boy, it is a dinger, as Johnny Orr calls it here at Hilton Coliseum. We hope you're enjoying it wherever you're watching across the United States. And, of course, across the state of Iowa, too. And if you think it's hot at home, boy, you ought to be in here tonight.
Well, it's too
loose in the tie.
Well, I'm too excited to get with that tie, but it's too bad that every person in the state couldn't be here to see it in person. But those that can't, we're glad they're watching on our Cyclone Television Network, because you couldn't ask for a better ball game. This is the type of game that's built up to what it's been, and a lot of times they don't come off like that.
No, they don't. So far in the ball game, LaFesta Rhodes has been the story for Iowa State, and Ed Horton has been the hero for the Hawkeyes.
Well, with this overtime, it gives LaFesta Rhodes a chance to break the Iowa State scoring record and the Hilton Coliseum scoring record. And I just noticed BJ come out to center court talking to official, and he had a smile on his face, and I think he's breathing a little easier and feels like, well, we got life.
5 minutes in the overtime period. LaFesta Rhodes, 48 points on the board right now. I guess he did break it then with 48, those free throws.
We got him on 48.
We have 48 on the board. We'll check
all
our
right.
official stats.
We missed him on one.
He did set the record. And Ed Horton has 19, Bill Jones 21. And here we go with overtime. Tip control momentarily by Iowa State. Then off the foot of Bill Jones, and it'll go back to the Cyclones. Jones had the steal for a second.
He has done an excellent job, Bill Jones. He had the ball there. He was going to make a big possession. Just unfortunate the ball bounced off his foot.
Tompkins, trouble getting it in. Gets it into Woods. Here they come. 3-on-2. Over to Dreher. And he'll hold up.
Good, smart play by Dreher that time. Nothing but an offensive foul going to happen if he takes it up and in.
Iowa playing a zone again. And Dreher sliding along the high post. If Iowa State should miss, there's no one underneath. But they don't even get a shot away. They turn it over, and Armstrong up with the basketball.
They've got Dorfell on one side trying to bring Dreher out where he get a chance for the ball.
Foul out on the floor. On the dribble against Terry Woods. Armstrong will be at the line.
I mentioned earlier in the ball game, with about 5 or 6 minutes to go, that Armstrong seemed to be coming to life, and it's game time. It always seems to me like he's a gamer, and he has come to play in the last 6-7 minutes.
Keep in mind that Iowa State held a 9-point lead, the widest margin in the contest in the second half. Misses it. Somebody's in the lane too soon. And a lane violation. Armstrong came into the ballgame hitting 13 of 13. He has missed 2 in a row tonight. But that one doesn't go in the book. That's an alternate throw now.
And you'd have to credit that to Iowa's offensive rebound ability to get in on the free throw line. It caused Iowa State to check early.
So officially in the scorebook now, Armstrong will be 1 of 2. Alternate throws don't count. It made a difference, as you can well tell.
Big violation.
Armstrong with 12 points in the game. And again, Tompkins with trouble getting the ball in against the press.
Iowa State has done a good job in that pressure standpoint, that the inbounds man will run with the basketball after the made basket free throw, which you can do, and release himself from that pressure of the big guy.
Ed Horton down low saying, hands up, hands up. I would think that the pressure now is on Iowa State. They've been running for 40 minutes, and now they have to run for 5 more. Can they keep up the pace?
And one thing, that guy has not had the ball for a long time, and he still is able to shoot the ball down.
LaFesta Rhodes with 51 points, and Iowa State reclaims the lead 93-92. Horton doesn't fall.
They've got a miss there.
Here's a 2-on-1. Woods.
And Woods made it. Beautiful play there. He looked the defensive man off as if he was going to pass, got him to drop back, and then went up.
Armstrong. And Dorfeld now with a rebound. Up court to Woods. Seven unanswered points, and Tom Davis calls time.
Iowa State doing big rebound by Grayer again, coming out, and just as the ball game after the first 8 or 9 minutes, Iowa State being able to get out of there quick with their speed and get down and get that numbers game, 2-on-1. Look at Elmer Robinson, the Iowa State bench. Elmer, of course, is fouled out of the ball game. Here's the play. That time the defensive man sacked back. A push. Grayer gets away with a push right there underneath as Woods missed. But LaFesta Rhodes, beating Iowa's big people back all night long, comes through with another great tip. Well, you see the stat there. Iowa State, I think, had scored over 100 points in every home ball.
Because of the overtime, we may have to change transponders, so listen closely and we'll inform you of that if that possibility occurs. 3 minutes, 19 seconds. 97-92.
For the Hawkeyes. Well, with this overtime, it gives Professor Rhodes a chance to break the Iowa State scoring record in the Hilton Coliseum scoring record. And I just noticed BJ come out to center court talking to official, and he had a smile on his face, and I think he's breathing a little easier and feels like, well, we got life.
5 minutes in the overtime period. LaFesta Rhodes, 48 points on the board right now. I guess he did break it then with 48, those free throws.
We got him on 48.
We have 48 on the board. We'll check
all
our
right.
official stats.
We missed him on one.
He did set the record. And Ed Horton has 19, Bill Jones 21. And here we go with overtime. Tip control momentarily by Iowa State. Then off the foot of Bill Jones. And it'll go back to the Cyclones. Jones had the steal for a second.
He has done an excellent job, Bill Jones. He had the ball there. He was going to make a big possession. Just unfortunate the ball bounced off his foot.
Tompkins, trouble getting it in. Gets it into Woods. Here they come. 3-on-2. Over to Grayer. And he'll hold up.
Good smart play by Grayer that time. Nothing but an offensive foul going to happen if he takes it up and in.
Iowa playing a zone again. And Grayer sliding along the high post. If Iowa State should miss, there's no one underneath. But they don't even get a shot away. They turn it over, and Armstrong up with the basketball.
They've got Dorfell on one side trying to bring Grayer out, but he gets a chance.
Foul out on the floor. On the dribble against Terry Woods. Armstrong will be at the line.
I mentioned earlier in the ball game, with about 5 or 6 minutes ago, that Armstrong seemed to be coming to life, and it's game time. It always seems to me like he's a gamer, and he has come to play in the last 6-7 minutes.
Keep in mind that Iowa State held a 9-point lead, the widest margin in the contest in the second half. Misses it. Somebody's in the lane too soon. And a lane violation. Armstrong came into the ballgame hitting 13 of 13. He has missed two in a row tonight. But that one doesn't go in the book. That's an alternate throw now.
And you'd have to credit that to Iowa's offensive rebound ability to get in on the free throw lane, and it caused Iowa State to check early.
So officially in the scorebook now, Armstrong will be one of two. Alternate throws don't count. It made a difference, as you can well tell.
Big violation.
Armstrong with a dozen points in the game. And again, Tompkins with trouble getting the ball in against the press.
Iowa State has done a good job from that pressure standpoint that the inbounds man will run with the basketball after the made basket or free throw, which he can do, and release himself from that pressure of the big guy.
Ed Horton down low saying hands up, hands up. I would think that the pressure now is on Iowa State. They've been running for 40 minutes, and now they have to run for five more. Can they keep up the pace?
And one thing, that guy has not had the ball for a long time, and he still is able to shoot the ball down.
Professor Rhodes with 51 points, and Iowa State reclaims the lead 93-92. Horton doesn't fall.
They've got a mismatch.
Here's a two-on-one. Woods.
And Woods made it. If he's going to pass, got him to drop back, and then went up high. Made a tough shot.
Armstrong. And Dorfell down with the rebound. Up court to Woods. LaFesto Rhodes trips it in. And LaFesto Rhodes with 53 points. And Iowa calls timeout. 97-92. Iowa State roars back with 7 unanswered points. And Tom Davis calls time.
Iowa State doing a big rebound by Grayer again, coming out, and just as the ball game after the first 8 or 9 minutes, Iowa State being able to get out of there quick with their speed and get down and get that numbers game. It's 2-on-1. Look at Elmer Robinson, the Iowa State bench. Elmer, of course, is fouled out of the ball game. Here's the play. That time the defensive man sagged back. A push. Grayer gets away with a push right there underneath as Woods missed. But LaFesta Rhodes beating Iowa's big people back all night long comes through with another great tip. Well, you see the stat there. Iowa State, I think, they've scored over 100 points in every home ball.
Closely stations, because there is a chance you may have to change transponders. Because of the overtime, we may have to change transponders. So listen closely, and we'll inform you of that if that possibility occurs. 3 minutes, 19 seconds. 97-92, Iowa State. It was tied at the end of regulation at 90.
Side early that time with DJ again running off. Iowa State played good defense. There's the rub.
Blocking.
Hey. What has to happen on that play from Iowa State standpoint, when they set that pick, the big man for Iowa State has got to get out there hitch early. He cannot let that guard come around with that freedom and then try and catch up. He's got to get out there hitch, show himself, and make him hold up on his dribble.
All right. A word for our watching, we will be able to stay on this satellite transponder. So stations, you will not, repeat, not have to change transponders. DJ Armstrong at the line. And now he has the range. He is now officially 3 of 4. Just under 3 minutes to play, 2:58 remaining. '97-'94, Iowa State.
That's where they had success early, just going over the top.
Tompkins almost got caught midair. And Rhodes doesn't hit it. Lorenzen down with it.
Iowa that time came with a 1-3-1 half-court trap.
2.5 minutes. Horton almost.
Dorfell, a nice. Sorry. I'm going to say Dorfell, a nice job keeping his hands out of the shooter.
Offensive foul inside against Terry Woods. The basket will not count, and that's 4 fouls on Woods. And Iowa will have a 1-1 on the other end. and a chance to come back to within one.
Call this foul. You're looking now at concern Johnny Orr. Here comes Woods. Comes down, moves in. Instead of moving away and out to the side and getting away from the charge right there, he runs into the man, picks up the foul, and good defensive position by this guy right here, Armstrong. I said he's a money player.
Boy, is he ever, especially at the free throw line. Came in 13 of 13 on the year. And he's draining them when they count most.
What?
That was the fifth straight free throw by BJ. It's back to a one-point ball game. 97-96, Iowa State. Greer, here comes a three-on-one. And Greer doesn't like the looks of it. He'll slow it up. Rhodes with a body fake. Reverse layup, doesn't hit it. And the rebound comes down to Armstrong. And Iowa with a chance to reclaim the lead. Down to the 2 minute, 5 second mark.
Pretty good play by Rhodes. He had under inside. He couldn't take it up on the side that he wanted to, but tried to reverse it up, just did not get the ball down. Iowa a chance to retake the lead.
A lot of bumping and shoving inside. Jones stripped of the ball by Rhodes. But a foul on the arm called by referee London Bradley. And on Rhodes, that is foul number four.
Foul number five, Chester Rhodes, is four.
Johnny Orr unhappy with LeFester on that, just simply reaching in. And team free throws are keeping Iowa State or Iowa in the ball game as Bill Jones ties it. Iowa shooting 76% as a team. And Jones gives Iowa the lead, 98-97, 1:50 to play. Jones with 23 in the ball game. And since Iowa's been hustling back, dropping off the pressure, Iowa State's been having trouble getting its offense in gear until Jeff Greer gets his hands on the ball. And Greer now with 23.
Good jump pass by Woods, but a great job by Greer sealing his man off right behind him.
Iowa State averaging 104.6 points a game at home. Armstrong backdoor.
Good cut. I mentioned earlier that it's been every game at home, but Arizona State was the one game that they did not get
199. A minute three. They got to be looking for Greer. He'll take it from three. Doesn't hit it. Tompkins wants to fire it back up. Finger rolls it. Doesn't hit it. Rebound. Dorfell. Loose ball. And Dorfell is tackled by Lorenzen. Lorenzen unintentionally falls all over Paul Dorfell, but no foul call.
I think Iowa State's going to get the ball out. Gary Tompkins with another key offensive rebound. Comes in, makes a good fake, gets Lorenzen up. Finger rolls, but it's got spin on and comes out. You see the ball, Dorfell right here, now tries to get it, loses control, and then Lorenzen right over the top of it. There's another angle.
Just like horseback riding. Iowa State basketball, 49.5 seconds left to play. Shot clock reset. Iowa with a one-point lead.
Clock running down, the game clock, 42 seconds, so key for Iowa State needs to score because Iowa is able to run out the clock.
Woods from three-point range, short, loose ball, Iowa has it, and then they turn. Over to Rhodes.
What a save, a lot of action, the game just flip-flopping back one way or another. One team's seemingly having the game. Nice dribble by Jones.
Fester Rhodes came down with a perhaps game-saving rebound. He was tied up by Ed Horton. And Iowa State now will have the basketball and the lead and 10 and a half minutes or seconds left to play. We're trying to watch both coaches here. Johnny Orr will get charged with the timeout. So Iowa State is without any further timeouts in the ball game. Iowa still has one remaining. And let's look at the flurry.
And here comes Jones. Lost his footing there, a little off balance. Look at the shout right there on the inside by Horton. And Rhodes comes down with it. And he's swarmed by people, goes down, and they give him the jump ball. There's the other act. You see,
not so sure
Jones again. Smith might have been traveling, right? Couldn't see it. Ball comes out. There you can't see the push by Horton, but it's a battle underneath. Rhodes comes up with his quick jumping ability. And to be poetic justice, if Iowa State wins this ball game, then Rhodes hits the winning basket. He's got 55 points, 11 rebounds.
Fa-la-la LeFester. Well, the interesting point here is the fact that if there was a question mark at the start of the season whether or not Iowa State could be successful, it was at center. Sam Hill graduated. Daryl Spinks was ineligible academically. And so they converted LeFester Rhodes from a forward to a center. And everyone wondered, can he score? Well, tonight answers that question. A new Hilton Coliseum record, 55% or 55 points and 55% of the points also. 55 of 101.
Well, Iowa right now is in that situation, one down. They're going to probably have to look to get a quick foul because they've got a timeout left. And with 10 seconds, it's a lot of time. If they give up two free throws, they still have a chance to come down with a three-point play and tie the ball game. Or if they miss on the front end, they have a chance to win it with just a one-point lead. Again, crucial in here, you got to get the throw in. Watch for a release by Iowa State, maybe sending a guy down long.
Iowa State cannot call timeout. They've got to get it in. They do to Dorfeld. Back to Tompkins. Up court to Woods. All alone is LeFester. And he'll hold it. And he's fouled. With 9/10 of 1 second left on the clock. And Iowa State is going to win the basketball game. But the smartest play of the night was LeFester Rhodes holding the basketball. They call an intentional foul. So Rhodes will get two. And I think Iowa State gets possession.
Well, they will if it's intentional foul. That's the new rule, no doubt about it.
Tom Davis is up at the scorer's table. He doesn't like the call. But keep in mind, these are Big Ten referees.
Well, Johnny Orr is looking for a two-shotter.
Now, they're talking about whether or not it should be intentional. They may change it.
I'm betting it comes up one and one. Tries to get it. LeFester puts the ball on. Sees trouble. Goes up. Going to take some time off the clock.
No, I don't think it was intentional.
No, I surely wouldn't.
No. I think it was a legitimate non-intentional foul,
right,
and give him two shots for shooting, but not the official's arm goes up. It's not up yet. Yep, 2 seconds is right.
1-9. He's got a legitimate case.
He does. Tom Davis is right on the button. There should be 2 seconds. Well, actually, one more than what they have. 1.9. So we're arguing over 1 second. Violation. Bill Jones ran in after the ball was handed to LeFester Rhodes. They have to count it.
Well, Jones lost his poise.
They gave the free throw to Iowa State. And I believe there's timeout on the court.
Now they're going to get their timeout.
Iowa will use its last timeout. 9/10 of 1 second left on the clock. Iowa State with a two-point lead. 92 to 100. LaFesta Rhodes with 56 points in the ball game, and it appears, at least for now, 20th-ranked Iowa State is going to upset 7th-ranked Iowa. The official scores table, the basket counts. There is a violation for running into the lane after the ball was handed to the player, so they'll get another free throw. Now, I'd like to also have a shot of the Iowa State huddle here if we can, Bob, because there's a couple of players who are no longer going to be in uniform this year. Adrian Moore and Matt Morgenthaler, who started out the year with the team, have been redshirted, and they'll undergo a medical hardship this year because of injuries, so they will not dress with the squad anymore this year. But you can see that the celebration has started at Hilton.
Well, a lot of things can happen even we've got about 1 second left. You can think about a thing here as it goes through my mind. I've seen it many times. You've got the three-point rule. You can miss the free throw intentionally. By the time you can get the ball in playing down, you're going to have to throw it up from about 85 feet. You can make the free throw. Iowa gets it out of bounds. They can throw long down court and maybe get a shot, a three-point shot off to tie you. Those are slim odds. But I'm telling you, it happens. It can happen. I'm sure, not so sure that it wouldn't be a bad idea just to hit the ball up there, hit it on the rim and let it bounce high and stay away and make sure you don't foul. But you've got almost 1 second left.
Johnny Orr wants Iowa out of the huddle, but the officials are conferring in half court right now. They're having a conference. Let's see how many free throws now they give LaFesta Rhodes because of the lane violation. 9 tenths of a second left to play. 102 to 100.
My defensive players would all be in front of the three-point line if he's going to make this shot.
Johnny Orr doesn't have a player in the lane. He wants no chance of a foul. They give LaFesta Rhodes one more.
He's going to shoot it in. He can make it.
He doesn't hit it. Misses it. It's over. And Iowa State has upset 7th-ranked Iowa 102 to 100. And look at this. Uh-oh, trouble on the court. One of the assistant coaches trying to attack Johnny Orr. Dave Cox, the assistant athletic director, trying to separate the bodies right now.
Well, I don't know what precipitated that, but don't want to ruin a beautiful ball game. Either way, it's tough to lose. I'd say it either side.
The only bad thing about tonight's game was that one of these two teams had to lose. And I wish you could see the hug going on in half court between B.J. Armstrong and Gary Tompkins. Gary Tompkins and B.J. Armstrong literally put their arms around each other and gave each other a heck of a good hug.
Don't let anybody kid you that this game doesn't mean anything to anybody.
And look at that. There, that's Jesse Jackson, the presidential candidate, isn't it?
He's running for votes, isn't he?
Well, we'll finish this in just a minute. We'll be back in a moment. Iowa State wins this one in overtime.
Snake River, Wyoming, and Old Milwaukee both mean something great to these guys. The Snake River means fly fishing for Lunker cutthroat trout. And Old Milwaukee means a great beer. Cold, crisp Old Milwaukee beer. And smooth, golden Old Milwaukee light.
There's nothing like the flavor of a special place. An Old Milwaukee beer.
Old Milwaukee and Old Milwaukee light.
Fellas, it just doesn't get any better than this.
This has been a test. If it has caused a real pizza emergency, you are instructed to go directly to Pizza Hut and order their famous pan pizza with your favorite toppings.